Hey, how we doing? Are we doing hats backwards?
I want to put my eye patch, my ice eye,
Yeah,
Bausch and
should
Lomb TheraPearl eye mask. New sponsor of the show.
Long providing eye masks since 1842. I said in 1842 is just like a bag of ice.
Yeah, and a
Actually, it
guy
wasn't
that.
even a bag. They just put a piece of ice to your face.
And
That
none of
was
the pot.
before consumer protections.
The NAACP, I believe it's called.
Yes, they
What's the one that can say, what's the thing that protects OSHA? Is that
the National Council of
Health and Safety in the Workplace
Audio,
Podcast
Aviary,
Organization
and
Association?
the porthole was the vision because everyone looked through portholes back then. So,
Really? I thought that was just on ships.
yeah, no, everybody, they thought it was a cool thing, cool things that people that look stupid, like. You wear
Carrying
your
around a
underwear out of
porthole?
your pants. Everybody just carry around portholes.
I had no idea. I've never heard that
Yeah, it
before.
was a fad for a while.
Old porthole
You
fad.
know how fashion like goes in cycles?
I've
Like
never heard that before. It's an
the
interesting theory,
60s,
though.
the 1960s come back, 70s come back. How come like
Sure.
the 1860s never come back?
I got invited to a 70s theme party once, and I said, wouldn't it be cool if I went from as dressed from like the 1670s, not the 1970s? I thought that would be a cool little play on words.
What would you wear? Like
I don't know. Something
just
with fluffy arms, though.
shards of cloth from around your house?
I was picturing puffy shirts with the blousey arms on them,
Yeah.
buttoned all the way up to here, maybe a powdered wig, pants that I like those types of pants, like golfers wear, plus fours, they call them, or knickerbockers, I guess would be the word.
And people didn't complain back then at all.
How do
Like
you
it would be
know?
sweating, be
How do you know they
hot.
didn't complain?
Well, not at all, but like baseball players played in full like wool
I bet they
during the
hated it.
summer.
Yeah.
They said it was all, hey, this is awesome.
I
Let's play some
love
ball.
breathable. Yeah. Go get your winter sweater. Let's play some ball.
Yeah. All right, Ty Cobb, I'll go get it right now. And then he'd say something racist and they'd all leave.
N-word, go get my duck boots.
Yeah. And
Duck boots
then
and why did they wear wool? It's
I
just because that
don't
was
know.
the only thing they knew how to make jerseys out of.
I guess so.
Yeah, but they not have cotton back then? The cotton gin was before baseball, wasn't it?
I don't know. Must have just been cool.
Like,
Everybody
would you
got
guys
wool.
rather? Hey, you're gonna be out in the you're boys of summer. Hey, welcome back, guys. All right, we're at the uniform meeting for the year. Would you guys? Do you guys want what you've been wearing all winter to stay warm, or should we make it out of breathable cotton? What do you guys think?
Probably saved money in some way. I bet it just lasted longer and the owners didn't care. They're like, these wool uniforms will last 5 years. The cotton ones will last two.
Yeah.
They're wearing wool. If
Yep.
anybody dies, that's on them.
Myopia is nearsightedness.
Okay. And that means
Way
you
up.
can see near or you don't see near. Which one is it?
It's a vision condition in which people can see close objects
Yes.
clearly, but objects farther away appear blurred. Myopic, like the word myopic.
That makes sense.
A
Near
myopic view of the
nearsighted
world.
means you can see things near.
Yeah.
That's what I am. I'm
I can see
nearsighted.
this microphone perfectly right now. Like I'm staring at it, it's right there.
It's weird to me that people wouldn't be able to see things close but could see things far.
I'm that. That's how
Really?
my. Well, just in the past few years, I have a hard time reading my computer screen without reading glasses. But
Wow.
I can still see read far away signs fine. I was just doing that the other day. I was walking in the back here, and I was like, I can still read that sign, and it looks like it's got to be 50 yards away from me.
What if you sit 10 feet from your computer? Could you just read the screen?
I'm not. So what I'm going to do is I'm knocking out the wall in the back there. I'm going to make the store about 40 feet longer than it is right now.
You just need a wireless keyboard. It's like,
So I'm
what are
not.
you, where are you shipping it to?
Please don't walk any further. I hate when people walk behind my desk here and come.
Oh, people do that?
Yeah. People are wicked pushy nowadays. There's a
That's
lot of just
old.
very pushy people.
What do they do when they walk behind? Just.
They're like, put your pants back on. That's disgusting. This is a
Well, that
business.
could be a reason to
No,
get
they'll
rid
be
of.
they want a certain size box, and I keep my little thing of boxes behind where I'm like, hey, I'll go grab your box for you. You just tell me what size you need. They're like, well, I don't know what size. And then they just walk back there. I'm like, you don't just go and touch a guy's cardboard. You know, that's...
There's Wouldn't it be great that, if you had an electroshock field that they want?
I've been thinking about getting a cattle prod. I thought if I figure I cattle prod one guy, probably everybody will find out that I did that, right?
How about you could have the collar fence, but you have to put hey, to check you out, you have to put on this collar. You have to have everyone put it on and then take it off. And when they have it on, they walk past that thing and they just get zapped.
Thing is, I'm in Florida, and you know how Floridians are. We like our freedoms. I don't want to be chipped. I'm not.
So nobody would wear the collar.
Nobody's gonna go for it.
But you're probably allowed to cattle prod them, though.
That's what I'm saying. I think the easier one is just for me to get a cattle prod. Cattle prod one or two dudes, and then everybody's like, "All right, if you're willing to go to jail for me to not have to walk back there and touch your cardboard."
There's got
to
be a snappy sign you could get. If you walk over this line, I'll f-ing prod you or something like that.
Yeah, I probably shouldn't put the word though on out there, although I guess if I'm willing to cattle prod somebody, I'm probably also willing to say the word in public.
You'd just be like America. Yep, old cattle prod nine loth. Where you just come up with a nickname for yourself? Good old no. Cattle prod.
I've only gone down this road a few times. You're trying to constantly give me new nicknames. Can I be
no scared? But if the store people thought your nickname was cattle prod, they might not mess with you.
I should cattle prod them.
And I walked the first hole of the golf course.
How was that?
Wonderful.
Could you see yourself hitting good shots and walking triumphantly?
I just visualized it. Yeah,
that's a good habit to get into, visualization.
Yeah,
that helps your performance. Absolutely.
I walked with my in-laws. They wanted to play.
Did you tell them?
They came up while we were moving, and they asked if they could play golf. So I walked.
Thoughtful.
I brought them over. You might have to cattle prod me. Maybe halfway through it, I might just start walking with you guys and let you guys hit.
I'd do that. I didn't do it with Aaron, but last time my friend Justin came down here, he was staying in Miami, and we went out to play one of those Doral courses, and it was me and him, and then they paired us up with a single player. And both Justin and the single player were sort of serious about it, and I don't normally really play very seriously.
Yeah.
And after about 12 holes or 13 holes, I get pretty bored. So I just, that's what I ended up. I think I left out, I stopped at the last six or whatever. But last year when Aaron was filming us playing, and I thought it would be in bad taste to not play out my holes. But I think it would be very funny if that's what you did.
Yeah. Are we going to play? Is this going to be serious on Friday?
What do we mean? What do you mean serious?
Like you just said your friend Justin and this other guy were serious. You explained them as serious.
Well, Aaron tries. I try, but
it's
I don't.
It's okay to try, but it's like some. It's like the attitude, right?
No, it's not. I mean, I'll get very angry if you hit too many bad shots, but I'll give you one or two. Like
really,
scullers across the ground. Yeah, but if you just start shanking everything, I'm gonna freaking.
Dude, I haven't swung a golf club in 15 years.
Doesn't matter. I don't care.
And I'm probably going to miss a bunch of them.
I don't want that. We're going to be on YouTube, Jarrod. I don't want to look like a couple of rookies out there trying to promote the mag room, trying to get our heels in the thing, and the, you know, trying to get something going here. You got to play sharp.
This is not going to be good.
When you know that I know that you know that.
Maybe I'm not even going to go. I'll just watch you guys. I'm going to watch you guys from the side.
Come on, it'll be fun.
I don't know. I'm getting nervous.
Really? Because you're going to be on camera?
No, just because I'm so self-conscious. Bad. Not even being bad. I'm self-conscious of wasting other people's time in my life.
Yeah.
So much that when I do those things, I feel like I'm wasting all of your guys' time.
But don't you think this is more of a social thing than an athletic thing?
I hope so.
It's me.
Just remember,
Aaron.
I'm really fragile. So if you how you play it is going to dictate the beginning.
I promise you. I beat myself up. I get mad at myself. I never get mad at other people. I promise. We're not short, Karen. We are vertically better than I hit everything else.
Really? It really alters
our BMI. Yeah, but I just I'm usually good at those kind of things. I'm good at hitting things. I don't know what that means.
If I could hit it 100 yards straight with one club, I would just hit that club till I was within 100 yards, and then I'd that's all I did.
100 yards. Say you want to go 150, and you
if I could hit it 60 yards straight,
And no, you can hit it straight 150 yards.
You've seen me hit a baseball. It's not going anywhere, Mark.
Well, the ball's not even moving in golf. All you have,
it doesn't matter. Makes it harder.
You just watch. No, you just watch it. Just don't take your. Everybody takes their eye. Any sport where hitting a ball is involved, people take their eye off the ball.
Yeah,
it's your natural instinct to want to watch where the ball is going. But if you can just keep your eye on the ball, you'll be fine. That's all you have to do. Watch the ball and swing through it.
My cousin won the best round I ever played. Probably the last time I played.
Or
like my cousin was yeah. I got 9 holes. I was 18 under for the roll. But whatever, I quit after that. No, he said, just keep your head still. That was like easier than I think the eye on the ball. Like it's the same outcome, but he was like, don't move your head.
Mm-hmm.
Just keep your head. And so that's your eyes on the ball, head still. You swing and you don't move your head ever. He said, just leave it there. Rest of the match. Don't move it. And then they played nine, came back and got me at the end.
We picked you up, under your arms and walked with you the rest of the way.
We got some lunch and
drinks. Jarrod follows directions well. I'll give him that. It's
unbelievable. That's anything else you got? What do we got?
I thought a couple of weeks ago we determined that I don't say your name enough. We don't really like.
Yes. Oh, we didn't introduce the show.
Oh, yeah. Say it real quick.
Sunday night.
Mag Room,
Mark and Jarrod.
All around the world you can hear them.
Hey, hey, hey.
Talking about using kind of funny stuff.
Hey, hey, hey.
Mag Room. The Mag Room. The Mag Room.
I thought I would say your name a couple of times and we could talk about Jarrod.
I think I need to change my name.
Get to know Jarrod.
No, I think I need to change my name. I'm serious.
To what?
So the Movers. We introduce ourselves to the Movers. They're like, oh, what's your name? Like Jerry. He's like, Jerry. And I'm like, Jarrod.
Jarrod.
And he said something
Jarrod.
Else. And I'm like, Jarrod. And then during the whole day, the guy would always ask for Michelle. And then one time he saw me. And he had to ask me, and he was like, hey, Jarrod. He like mumbled it fast enough where he couldn't remember what it was. And I'm like, this sucks. I just need to change my name. Maybe we'll have a listener thing for me to change my name. I'm thinking Rod. Just go with Rod.
Really? You're totally fine with having a penis name for a first name.
For sure. Or pretzels. It could go with pretzel rods people like.
Does
anyone ever call their penis a rod?
I constantly call my penis a rod.
Really?
Check out my rod, yeah.
Like, that doesn't seem like a good...
No, but everybody knows
that.
That's
you say that a lot? Hey, check out my rod.
Look at my rod. Guys, does my rod look weird? Does my rod look weird tonight? It's been bothering me.
I got some pus coming out of my rod. Can you check that out? No, Rod, you think of pretzels, of fishing. It's not a big
Everybody
penis
thinks of penis,
it's
yes.
Not.
Listeners,
not.
Please send a postcard in with just the word either penis or pretzel on it to the Mag Room. 10152 Indian Town Road, P.O. Box 9, Jupiter, Florida, 33478. Rod, pretzel or penis.
Or fishing.
It's more than 50%.
Or a curtain rod. There's so many other uses of rods. Used a lot.
Nobody first thinks of curtain rod. I'll give you fishing rod. I don't think I give you pretzel, but you did say something else in there that...
Pretzel rods? You don't know. That's like a brand of pretzels. I just stand up and tell him my new name like this. Hey, everybody, I'm going by Rod now. Just wanted you to all know.
Oh, my God. He named himself after a penis, not a pretzel. I was thinking about curtain rod. Shut up, Jane. Nobody thought about a curtain rod.
I could be like, you call me Rod or Dick. Either one is fine.
Hog. You can call me Hog. All right, Rod. So my whole thing was that I wanted to tell the listeners about Jarrod. And the first thing is that you no longer want to be known as Jarrod. So.
Yes.
I guess, I don't know. That took a turn I didn't expect.
Still go with it. Let's see.
All right, Rod. Where'd you grow up, Rod?
Well, that's a great question.
We're just getting to know you. That's
how do you I was thinking of that today when we moved to this house because my kids are 13, 11, and 6. And I was thinking for myself, I moved to New Milford, Connecticut when I was 11. And I probably count that as where I grew up, even though I had 11 years before that at other places, which is just weird to me because I only was in New Milford for 7 years before I went to
Yeah, but the guys that I know that you're friends with now, they're all from that post 11 age. So that seems to me like that's where you sort of got an identity and a.
Well, it's really hard to hang on to middle school friends when you move.
Yeah. What's the name of your high school? New Milford High School, right?
That's it. Yeah. NMHS.
What's the name of your middle school?
Scaticoke. It was after an Indian tribe that lived in New Milford.
Scaticoke Middle School.
Yep. People would go with SMS.
Kind of sounds like dirty porn stuff.
Yeah, there was also a dirty porn store near it.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah.
So named the middle school after a porn store?
Scaticoke's Rods, it was called.
Ugh, that sounds disgusting.
Yeah.
So New Milford, a big bustling city, I imagine. The old Milford was such a little...
No, it's like 20,000 maybe, like a middle town. So it was
little
very hamlet? Sprawling.
Little hamlet in Connecticut. Okay.
Longest green in New England.
Longest green. Town
like
green?
Town green, yep. They light it up with all these Christmas trees in the winter. It's very nice, all lit up. It has a nice downtown, like a New England-y downtown.
Like and a dairy shop where you can buy...
No.
Is there a place that you can buy ice cream that's made by the farmers themselves? Yeah.
No. Okay. I don't think they have a farmer ice cream place.
There used to be one somewhere near where I grew up in Cheshire. I can't remember.
There's a great one down there. Rich Farms. Oh, tremendous ice cream.
There was a place that near me that used to make pumpkin ice cream in the fall. And I always liked that a lot.
That's nice.
It was very like not in your face pumpkin flavor.
Yes.
A delicate pumpkin flavor.
That's what I always get worried about. They actually have, so they have frozen yogurt in the dining hall and they get different, it's from a local farm, and they get different flavors. The one I was hesitant to try was maple, and it was really good because it was just a hint of like syrupy to the ice cream that was like
right. Tasty. Not gritty, sugary.
No, it wasn't overpowering.
Overbearing, yeah.
I know we went to breakfast today, or for lunch, we went to breakfast.
Every time you talk about a meal, it's always breakfast at the breakfast at a non-breakfast.
We ate dinner at the morning when we woke up.
Do you eat dinner breakfast?
You're going to see when you get here. We went to breakfast for...
We had surf and turf for breakfast.
No, the kids love pancakes. They love pancakes. So they had to go to the urgent care because they both have this weird rash. That's what happened last. That's why we didn't record last night. Brennan had a rash and Teddy pooped in the tub. It was like, and then my life was over. I just like put on a movie for them and slept on I didn't even go to the fireworks. I was like, forget it. But they ordered pancakes and it came with like the Smucker's syrup. Okay. And both of them were like, what's this disgusting syrup? We had to buy the maple. They only like the pure maple syrup, not the.
Oh, they're like syrup snobs?
Yes.
That's kind of a cool thing to be a snob about, maybe.
Sure. But syrup's wicked expensive now. There's actually a syrup mafia in Canada.
Really?
Yeah, they keep the supply down. If you overdo it, they come to your house and like wreck your shit. There's a whole story online about it. We learned about an econ.
Oh, you're not joking.
No, not it's like the oil like OPEC and they have a cartel where you have to join and you have to be part of the thing and they fix the price and can only sell a certain amount or they come wreck your shit.
That's crazy.
Hey. Yeah, for syrup. You thought that they were all just like nice Canadians making say.
You want me to keep going here?
New
Milford. Where did you go from New Milford? Did you go to college?
I went to Wake Forest. No, I went to MIT first.
That's right.
For a couple months, and then I dropped out. Then I went to Western Connecticut State University for a semester.
Shout out to WestCon.
Yeah, the Colonials, I think. Then I transferred to Wake Forest University.
That's where I went.
Yeah. And I used to love eating lunch in the mag room.
Is that how we got the name of this place? Wake Forest University. Home of the Demon Deacons. Basketball, football, baseball.
All of those. Yes.
I was just talking the other day about...
I don't know if you want to list every
golf,
sport.
Golf, softball, volleyball.
Tennis.
Futons.
That's what you're going to sleep on at our house.
Is futon a borrowed word? Is it a word from some other language that means torture device or anything like that?
We got a nice little mattress topper for it. I think you'll be comfortable.
Am I on a futon at your house?
You are, yeah.
Oh, no. Am I really?
Yeah.
I was just giving you my actual feelings on futons, and now I have to go sleep.
Well, you
on
have
it.
A choice. There's another
can
mattress
I sleep in your
you
bed
can
with
put
you
on
and
the
Michelle?
Floor.
I won't sleep. Can I sleep not in between you and Michelle? I'll let you guys sleep next to each other, and I sleep on the other side of you?
No.
Come on.
It would be so hot. Three
of us
in
a queen. King?
You wouldn't even let me. You wouldn't even let me see your bed. Your bed is like a king size.
Yeah. Do you have a king or a California king?
No, we just have a queen.
What?
Yeah.
I have to sleep on a queen with you two? It's got to be.
We have a trundle bed that pulls out from the boys. You could bunk with them on their trundle bed.
Grundle. Remember the word grundle from when you were a kid? What's a grundle bed? I've never heard of that before.
Trundle. Trundle bed. You pull it out from under, like it hides
smell
underneath.
Like grundle?
Yes.
Is that a borrowed word?
Yes. I don't know. I don't know the actual definition of grundle. It's like we thought it was the skin between your...
Your butthole and your penis. Your balls.
I don't know if that's the actual meaning.
I think it is.
So, yeah. You got it. And then we have these nice sleep mats that are pretty thick. You can make your choice. I can give you some choices.
Okay.
Futon has a topper, though. People have said it's comfortable. We got like a mattress topper.
I'm half kidding. I'm not really...
I don't think you'd want to sleep on it long term. Why don't you try a couple of them and then you can report back? You could try the... Well, you got two nights. Try one night with the topper with the futon. It's not, it doesn't go well. You could try one of the sleep mats.
Can I be honest with the reviews? Can I be scathing with my futon review?
If you have to be honest, though, you can't just be scathing to be funny. You have to be honest.
Okay. All right. So you guys excited for the mattress review, the futon mattress review in 2 weeks, I guess?
No, next week. Pretty, it'll be next week little, on
yeah,
the
but
show.
It's gonna get, but it's going to get produced in 2 weeks, right?
Yeah, but they hear it the next week.
Oh, yeah. But I'm talking about now. But I'm talking about now. Well, wait. It just blew my own mind.
Yes, you did. Well, also, it depends when we record the show, because you might have only slept on one mattress at that point. It might have to be a two-part review.
If you guys aren't excited, this is such a good tease. Two-part mattress, two-part scathing mattress review of Jarrod's trundle bed,
yeah.
Grundle bed, and...
Yes. I was going to look up grundle.
And mattress topper.
Yeah, the region between the anus and the genitalia.
Yeah.
It says vulgar. And then it says...
Wait, vulgar? So do I have to beep that out?
I think so.
Can I leave one in? Grundle.
Ain't, grundle, gooch, and derf.
I've never heard derf, but I've also heard ABC. I feel like we've talked about this before. ABC, your ass balls connector. I liked that you were texting me questions about now that you've moved into a house, you've got some handyman issues.
Sure.
You were trying to get out some stripped screw and a wing nut that would have been, I guess, rusted.
The wing nut worked. The strip screw did not.
So what happened? What went wrong with the strip screw?
The drill just was like and didn't go through it.
Do you have, so Jarrod's issue is that he has to extract.
Well, I just left it. I didn't do it. I just left it there.
Do you have, they call it a punch. It's like a piece of metal with a point on the end and you can hit it with a hammer and it'll make a little indentation and that helps you get your drill bit started.
I have a toolbox filled with just a pile of shit. So it might be in there. I have no idea.
I'll start sending you some stuff.
You got to write down.
I have extra punches and stuff like that.
You got to write down what you use them for.
Or you'll figure it out. Sort
Why don't we do that on the show? You could send me something and then you educate me about it on the show. Like a Bob Vila part with Mark Einlein.
Can I just bring a punch on an airplane with me nowadays? Probably not.
I don't. Probably not.
It's intentionally heavy and pointy.
I was just showing my friend for a podcast, I promise.
My friend Jarrod's never extracted a stripped screw before. All right, we're going to keep in this room over here. Just for a couple of minutes.
We're going to show you the rod, the anal rod.
Do you mean the pretzel
kind? It's going to go through your gooch.
You mean pretzels?
You mean my friend Rod Sisk?
That's Jarrod.
All right. Well, so I need some emails about my name. I guess we learned some things about Jarrod Sisk. Maybe somebody,
Jarrod, the host of the show, Jarrod Sisk.
Maybe somebody will remember my name. All right, I just got the dinner call, so we got to whip through this one.
Oh, okay.
I wanted to say also, Teddy's real excited for you to visit. He's asked at least 3 times, when's Mark coming? How long is he staying? So,
okay.
Got a lot to build up to live up
hey,
to.
What do you think I need to...
If you play dinosaurs with him once, that's all, you'll be great.
That's the expectation?
Probably.
One round of dinosaurs?
Well, and you could just talk to him otherwise.
I could kind of walk like a dinosaur. You know how they like...
If you just
walk back and forth,
if you act
like a bird,
like a pachycephalus, like you like clean yourself and you go, that's your first time you see him. You just walk around and do that.
You don't think I'll think I'm crazy?
Nope.
Just go for it. Just go for the dinosaur thing right off the bat.
Go for it.
I feel like I'm getting set up here, but...
No, I think you'd like it. I mean, okay. Michelle might be like, what the hell's going on, but...
Yeah.
It's a different audience, so you got to decide which audience.
Know your audience. That's a big part of comedy. Achiosaur, huh?
So I assume you like some civil disobedience when it's for a good cause.
Yeah.
I was thinking of this the other day, and this isn't really civil disobedience, but I saw some graffiti. Like someone had like spray painted something.
Okay.
And I'm like, well, how does that get to happen? Like
why isn't it covered up right away?
No. Like who carries around spray paint and then spray paints like Mark loves Jarrod or something like that on the garbage can?
Not Mark. Somebody else. It wasn't me. I'm not even up there yet. Couldn't have been me.
Maybe I wrote it, but
yeah,
it seems like a lot of planning. To do, like, you're not just carrying that stuff around.
Well, that's what graffiti artists do.
Yeah, but this isn't like art, this one. The graffiti artists are different than just spray painting.
Just bad graffiti. They're just bad graffiti artists.
I see. So they're trying to be artists, but
yeah, they'll eventually, when you're 16, you don't have a whole lot to say.
I see. So you're going to still call me a golfer even when I play golf, even though I'm not.
Jarrod, you walked a single hole of golf today. You're already a golfer as far as I'm concerned.
Sign me up. So this was about, this article was called, Grumpy Locals Are Sabotaging Cruise and Waymo Robotaxis with Traffic Cones. So self-driving cars, right? In San Francisco, they've allowed some of them. These companies called Cruise and Waymo. They're self-driving taxis. You get in, you tell where Waymo it wants to go. So all they do is put cones around and cones on the seat, on the hood. And if you put a cone on the hood, the car just gets stuck. It doesn't know how to move with the cone. It's hood.
Wait, the car, if you put it on the car, the robot car, if you put a cone on the hood.
Okay. It can't drive.
Wonder why. Wonder what that safety feature is. I guess anybody's sitting on it.
Or if you put like cones in the road, it doesn't know what to do. But they put these cones on the hood and the things couldn't drive.
I remember hearing about it. There's been a couple of deaths, or a dog died, right? In San Francisco.
I mean, the question will become, are humans worse drivers than the robots? And probably, right? There's probably more deaths with the
robots. I mean, the human?
The human drivers than robot drivers.
Yeah, but I would just take the traffic cone off the hood of my car if somebody put one down there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, I know how to do that.
I think they weld it on.
How do you weld plastic?
You know, with their plastic welder. It's called a plelder.
Yeah, you do need some tool knowledge, don't you?
So, yeah, I just thought of that with the graffiti. I was like, this takes a lot of preparation. And then the cones thing, these people really want to disrupt this. So it's interesting with that idea of civil disobedience. They're not really wrecking it. I mean, I guess the graffiti wrecks. It depends where you do it.
Let's see if I can get
that. How hot is it in Florida right now?
It was, I think it was 196 degrees with the heat index today. My pops was in the hospital this weekend.
Yeah, so how's he doing?
He's good.
Hope so.
But he's normally my my lawn care maintenance guy.
You're like, hey, Dad, get out of the hospital so you can mow my lawn.
Get out in the hot Florida sun. Yeah.
And then you ask the doctor, when will he be cleared to do lawn work?
So I called up the hospital. I'm bitching all morning long. I'm like, you got to let him out. I didn't get to cut last week because of the rain. If I go another week, I'm going to have mosquitoes every goddamn. Just let him out, please. Now you know he's fine.
Yeah, it's only 118.
So I was able to talk to Agarwal is his name. I was able to talk Dr. Agarwal into letting him out. And so the yard got done, long story short, but it was a hot-ass day today, man.
Yeah.
I'm driving around, and that's all I could think of. Because he likes to come out and do it. That's like his little weekend Sunday morning activity. And I'm sweating, and I got stuck. Had to yank all these palm fronds out from underneath, and... couldn't figure out what I was doing wrong. Took me like 20 minutes to get started again.
Mowing your lawn.
Yeah, I ran over. I got my blade stuck, and I thought I broke the belt, which I had just fixed. on the other mower.
Were you just trying to make your dad feel good by like totally sucking at it?
Well,
it,
no. Well, that's what I was thinking. I was like,
you just took pictures of yourself.
I'm like, I did about a D plus C minus job, Dad.
This was as good as the Argentinian singer woman I hired. Is that how good I did at mowing the lawn?
Actually, she did a better job than I did mowing the lawn. It was too wet. I got stuck a couple times. It sucked. And all I could think was like, what is he like about doing this?
They're just better. They're tougher people than we were.
But then when I was done, I was happy. I was like, all right, sure. I got that done. It felt good. Grass is nice. And hopefully there won't be quite as many mosquitoes.
You got to engage in the moment when you're doing it. That's what I've learned. You can't think about the other thing you could be doing. Like, oh, I could just be sitting in my house.
No, it was me getting stuck that frustrated me.
Sure.
I ended up having to take 20 minutes to, you know, those types of things are just bound to frustrate you.
So he's better. Did he get out or no?
Yeah. That's before I got here. I was
being,
over there.
He's just being lazy.
He's on the mower right now. No, now he's out weed whacking. It's dark now, but he can still weed whack right by the front porch because I leave the light on. He'll be okay. It's hot, but I left him a bottle of water.
Warm bottle of water out on the step.
Yeah,
Dad, you can't go in the house because you're gonna be a little grassy.
Just anywhere where the light shines. Just get that part. Anywhere where you can see. It's not that bad.
No, get him a headlamp. Then you can just go the whole thing.
That's probably true, Jarrod. I should have thought of that.
The kitchen's all set. The dining room's set. The bedrooms are. They just need to like. You need to now. It's all just like putting the shit away. Like. There's boxes of books. You got to put the books away.
Yeah.
Like all the stuff's where it is. And then there's one room that just has piles of shit. That's like the room that's going to be last. It has like everything that was stuff to put together. No, it's like the.
Futon.
It's going to be this cool like extra room with like a table. It's like the extra room.
What goes on in the extra room?
It's like a sitting. There's a fireplace. You'd sit. You'd like talk about things. Maybe I'll interview when I do my interview podcast. I'll interview people there.
You mean a podcast not with me, do you mean?
All right, let's wrap it up. Should we wrap it up?
Wait, but just real quick, what was that last little comment you made?
Produced by Rod Serling. Theme Rod song Serling. By Mega Yellox. Right? Do you know Rod Sterling? Or it's Rod Sterling, isn't it?
Rod Serling was the guy with the cool voice, right?
Yeah, Rod Serling, yeah.
Who's Rod Sterling? Oh, Donald Sterling. He's the guy with not a cool
I think Rod Sterling was a wide receiver for the Houston Oilers. Wasn't Rod Tidwell the guy from
Jerry Maguire?
Yeah. See, another Rod. Email mugaandcisco@gmail.com or write us a letter or a postcard. I'm sure we're going to get one. Magroom 10152 Indiantown Road, P.O. Box 9, Jupiter, Florida, 33478.
You know you're going to write penis on there. Just write penis. Nobody thinks of pretzels.
Pretzels or a curtain. I think curtain rod's going to win.
Absolutely nobody thinks of curtain rods. Penis, pretzel, curtain in that order. We should make those t-shirts. Penis, pretzel, curtain.
As you heard the history of Mark and Jarrod, the hosts of the show,
Jarrod,
when we stuck with the mag room in our lives, then everything else was cream cheese.
Good job, Jarrod.
Thanks, Bill.
Hey.
Ooh, I like mag room.
I like mag room.
Ooh, mag room is good.
Mag room is good.
Ooh, I like mag room.
I like mag room.
Ooh, mag room is good.
Mag room is good.
The mag room's good.
Ooh, I like mag room.
I like mag room.
Ooh, mag room is good.
Mag room is good.
Yeah, the region between the anus and the genitalia.